Okay, welcome to Kabuto Creations, and this is Workshop Wednesdays. So, what's on my workbench? Where I do a weekly update on the projects that I'm currently working on. The first one I'd like to showcase is my first official 3D print right here, which is for my Dr. Doom mask, which I'll show here. This file is already set up, already sliced into four pieces to fit on most current goods. Spring out of ABS. That's the filament that my 3D printer came with. I'm still cleaning up these prints. I'm back here at some more of the detailed areas, but this was the first thing I wanted to print out. And let me actually show you the first print, which is right here. I learned a lot. Actually, from this, I did not play around with the orientation when I exported the XDL file and sliced it. It was like so, and I had set for either too much raft or not enough raft or not enough support. And as we can see here, the print didn't finish, and when I found the print in the morning, it was off the print bed. But I still was amazed at the detail within it. And now since then, I've learned to play around with the orientation on the printer and try to minimize the amount of supports necessary for my print. So next piece was not this one, sorry, this one. So when you get the file, it's kind of up like this. So I rotated it about 30 degrees, so it was down here, and that's what I got. I'd say the detail is fairly, really good. Actually, no, I take that back. This one was also printed, I believe, but like this, in this orientation, but a lot more supports. The next file, this one, this bad boy, I had rotated about 30 degrees, and it came out wonderful, and I'm actually really happy with the print lines on this. I'm actually going to leave these instead of trying to to fill them in, because I'm going to play around with a Damascus steel effect. There should be more on that as this project comes along. The next thing I printed were these medallions slash emblems. I really enjoy comic books, and especially Marvel and S.H.I.E.L.D. So I created these. Don't know what I'm gonna do exactly with them yet. Definitely gonna finish these, and I kind of want to play around with some resin, which is why I picked up this right here. I'm gonna play around with that, and also a clear resin. I kind of want to turn this into a full medallion and fill these gaps with clear resin. So. As I finalize exactly what I'm going to do, of course I'm going to showcase this. These right here. I really enjoy these. And the amount of filament used to make them, yeah, wasn't that much, but it still pushed my first canister of filament over the edge. So after the Dr. Doom and the shield medallions. I wanted to make an upgrade. I have this new XYZ Printer Pro. I'm really satisfied with it. And it comes with these proprietary cartridge, filament cartridges. Looking on Amazon, the refills are actually more expensive than the cartridges themselves. They go from anywhere from $20 to $30, even upwards of $40. This one, I got rushed because I wanted to, well, the one I have in there, I bought another one, the black filament, but I bought rushed because I really wanted to finish the Dr. Doom project. I actually got that for about $25, not too much more. Still more than your third-party filaments. Not much more, but still more expensive. And you don't really get as much. I think this comes in about a pound or less, while some of the aftermarket third-party filaments are actually, maybe 2 pounds or so. Either way, searching on Thingiverse, I found a file for this, which hangs off, which is a spool holder, which allow me to use filaments not affiliated with XYZ. And I'm looking forward to testing this out this week with some new filaments. Hopefully some PLA. As much as I liked what I was actually able to do with the ABS, I hear it pales in comparison to PLA and the tolerances of those. I can't wait to play with that. So these are my 3D printed projects, if you will. I have another project, which is, I can grab it, a Halo ODST helmet made with EVA foam. The files are from Andrew DFT on YouTube, and he makes this whole thing look terribly easy. But the reason why I wanted to showcase this condition, was just to show you that this is actually my first attempt at making something so complicated, and especially with even with the templates, still not as easy as the professional YouTubers make it to be. And a lot of times when you're working on something, especially for the first time, you can kind of have your confidence wane because it doesn't look like what the expert did. I have a few friends working with EVA foam, and they kind of get discouraged because it looks a mess. And I haven't been working long in cosplay and prop making thing. I've only been dabbling with it, for years now. But now I want to get into it, a whole lot more and start doing some more complicated things, taking some more risks. I just wanted to show my progress with these things. And I'm not dissuaded from how this looks now, because with tons of body filler and sanding, I'm going to show you that even though this looks pretty messed up now, when all said and done, it's going to look amazing. So I want to show people that don't get discouraged. The end is a long way away, and there's tons of things we can do to fix this. Actually, looking at this right now, I kind of want to cut out the templates again and make another one along with this one, but we'll see how that goes. But I'm actually quite impressed with how it's shaping up. It doesn't look that much right now, but even when I did this first layer right here, it was able to give me a good impression of how well I actually was able to put it over my head. I have a huge head, so I wasn't expecting the templates to work for me, but I added this last night. I tell you, I had to cut this in half. He recommended. I have some thinner foam here, but looking at it now, I don't know if it was too thin or maybe just right, but I have some ideas for the second edition of this, but even still, I'm quite happy. I also bought a product to test out with it. He recommended hot glue, but I want to try contact cement. I know everyone uses a barge. I wasn't able to get a big one, but I know that this contact cement is somewhat similar, so I think what I'm going to do is the first project is the first version, or let's just call it Mark 1. It's going to be with hot glue, and I think the Mark 2 will be with this. So we'll see. I'll keep you updated. And I just want to reiterate again, do not be discouraged with your first, second, third attempts. Oftentimes these things take a while to master. I would call myself an apprentice at this point, but the few things I have finished, like my nerf guns and my first costume, which I won't even put up because of, I got compliments. I took it out on Halloween for trick-or-treating with a friend of mine and her children. Don't worry, we're not going to do this trick-or-treating, but I got so many compliments, and it's really what has driven me to continue and to start doing some more complex things, because as hard as a critic as you are on your own endeavors, people will look at it, and not all people, but people will look at it who haven't done it, or who won't, or like you, have been hesitant to do it, and think, I could never have done as good as you. When you get that compliment, it's just like, wow. I mean, I thought it was, not utter crap, but at least, bottom tier, but they're like, no, you made it yourself. That's amazing. So, that's why I'm showing this. I'm going to end here. I'm already starting to ramble. But this is the first Workbench Wednesday, or Workshop Wednesday, and this is the first segment of what's on my workbench. I hope to get better at these as I go along, and I hope they showcase my projects.